y'all don't mind, let's go back to a time we really used to have church. We used to have a good time, praising the Lord, in spirit and in truth.
I love them old
church. That old brother, pick up that old hymn book and
singing,
you knew exactly what he was gonna say. Sisters got happy. Folks start patting their feet, clapping their hands, and
singing,
all of a sudden, he break off in a song, something like this.
Sing. Yeah, and you are worthy to be praised. And certainly we are able to praise him. You have breath in your lungs and a movement of your body, and God has just gave you one day more than you deserve. You ought to be ready to praise God.
Amen.
Amen about it. So I
yes.
want you look at this lesson, and hopefully you'll help me and bless somebody's life. This is between you and the Holy Spirit. Take notes, take what you will, but most of all, apply to your everyday lives that we might be better Christians tomorrow than we were on yesterday. Amen?
Amen.
This lesson is important to me because it keeps me grounded. It keeps me firmly aware of what is happening around me all the time. Whether you know it or not, the enemy is always busy.
Man.
The enemy is always using somebody or something. And if you're living your life this morning thinking that the devil somehow is at rest, I have news for you. He ain't sleep.
No, he ain't.
But praise be to God that God don't sleep either. Amen.
Man.
As long as there's God, everything is going to be.
Yes.
All right. Amen. Look with me, if you will, at John chapter 10. Thank you, brethren, for the participation in service, and you and all, not that you do it for me, because I'm a man, I'm worshiping God too, but that we give glory to God in unison, praise our Lord and Savior.
Amen.
For he is the audience and we are the participants.
Yes.
But in John chapter 10, something is said that is very interesting. You can read right by it if you're not careful. But there are some people who fit the adjectives and the transitional movement of the text. There are some people in here right now that look just like this text. And then there's some folk in here that come here for no other reason but to praise God.
All right.
In spirit
and
truth.
And in truth.
Man. All
right.
There's somebody in the house of God that's not going to allow the devil
yes.
to look at them funny and shut them up.
Man.
Matter of fact, when somebody look at you this morning funny,
yes.
you say, praise God.
Anyhow.
Won't you look at your neighbor right now and say, praise him?
Praise
him.
Anyhow.
I know you on assignment and interest enough. The name of this lesson, the title of this lesson is He's on assignment. He's on assignment. When you get to work Monday, I want you to go to work and understand that he's on assignment.
Man.
And he's on assignment. Thank God that Christ is on assignment.
Man.
When you're driving down the street and they cut in front of you, just say, he's on assignment.
All right.
At home and your spouse not acting right, just say, he on assignment. He's on assignment because the text says, listen to what the text says. The text says, the thief cometh not for anything else. There are folk that you meet in your life that have no other reason to be in your life but to kill, but to steal your joy, kill your spirituality. Y'all got quiet right now. Y'all must know some of them folk.
Yeah.
There's some folk in your life whose main job is to steal,
yes.
and kill, and destroy everything that God has given to you. Yes. There are folk in your life that want to stop you from shouting and giving God glory right now.
Right.
There are folk that in your life that you've been trying to figure out, what is this person's problem? As long as I've known you, every time you come around, drama come around.
Right.
Every time I see you, I feel this funny feeling inside of me. And every time you're around, I'm walking on eggshells and I'm trying to figure out what's the deal with you. And there are folk on your job that you know you'd rather walk way down the hall than to just stand by. Y'all understand?
Yeah.
There are folk at your school who are on assignment. I want you to know that Christ says that the thief and his angels come not to do anything else. They have no other purpose in life than raising hell in your life.
Man.
Praise be to God that he says, I have come that they may have and sit by Jesus himself, and they're still going to be the same person because of their core value system. Listen to what he says when he talks about these folks. He says in John chapter 8 and verse number 44, he said, you are of your father, the devil. All right, he said, you are a murderer. You are a murderer from the beginning, and you will do the lust that the devil calls you to do.
Man.
Right, now, the devil's telling you to sit and look stupid.
Yes.
Man. And worry about everybody else instead of saying thank you, Jesus, for the word of God.
Man.
Something about the devils and his children, they like coming in the house of God and looking like they just died.
Man.
I don't know what's wrong with you, but every now and then you ought to look like God helped you eat this week.
Yes, sir.
You ought to say like God bless you with
You
ought to smile like God gave you life. But when a thief comes, his intention is to steal what God put in the church house. I don't know what's wrong, but God put joy.
Man, yes, sir. Preach
and
about
said,
it.
I was glad.
Yes, sir.
Said, come into the house.
Man, that's what he said.
I didn't come to the house of God to be looked at. I came to give God praise. You ought to lose your neighbors. I don't know what you came here for.
Yes.
But I came to give God praise.
Man.
Yes. You might have moved to a praise. Have you ever been to SeaWorld? You've been to SeaWorld and have a certain area called the Splash Zone.
Man.
You used to let Shamu be Shamu. Let him stop Shamu from being Shamu. Shamu is a wild whale when you got him. He's
Man.
A wild whale when you got him.
Yes.
His job is to swim deep in the water. He wasn't bothering nobody. You jumped on his back and rolled him down to the bottom.
Man.
Oh, am I right about it?
Man.
Now, some people's job is to stop the splash zone. That's the thrill zone.
Yes.
I want you to know that the Holy Spirit needs to splash right now and touch somebody, and despite your bills, and despite your headaches, and despite your enemies, despite the person not praising God, you ought to stand up right now and give God a shout like you never shouted for.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Like, why you met her? Why you met her? She came in your life. She was cute. He was cute. And said all the right stuff. You looked at him. You could have to have him or it. And you got with him. And then that monster got loose. And that monster started taking your money, messing up your credit, tearing up your cars, eating up your food, staying up your house, messing up your hair. You wearing a wig now and weave. He done made you go bald headed because you didn't understand that when you met him, he was on. He was on that evil. Now she wanna go home.
Man, yes, sir.
You met her. She was fine, wasn't she?
Oh,
she had on fake eyebrows, fake fingernails, a buddy. Fake hair, fake lips. Oh, you were smiling from ear to ear. She was smiling at you. But okay, then she was out at your job in the parking lot waiting on your check. That spent your money. Won't cook, won't clean, won't do nothing but what she want to do. Talking crazy, walking in front. You better have money. And you trying to figure out what's going on, but you didn't know that she was on.
A sign.
Do they frustrate you? Do they make your head? core value system is messed up. John 8, 44. Romans 3, verse 16 and 17. Because their core value system messed up, their character is always messed up. I mean, they're always miserable, complaining. They're always destructive, tearing up stuff. Whenever they come around, bad stuff seems to start happening. Every time they come, they're consistent. The Bible says in 1 Peter 5 and verse 8, that our adversary, the devil, goes to battle as a roaring lion, seeking whom?
Yes.
Revelation 12, verse number 10. All in the man, for the accuser of our brother has fallen down on the earth, which he stands in heaven, and he accuses the brethren day and night.
Yes.
You know them. They are negative in spirit, negative in conversation, misery, and debauchery, and anger is always in. You may know them. They say, I have a bad temper. Now you got a bad spirit. That's because you got a temper, you got a bad spirit. You need to recognize when somebody does not have My reason, Revelation 6 and verse number 2.
And I saw,
and behold, a white horse. I want you to watch this.
And he that sat on him had a bow.
He had a bow.
And a crown was given unto him.
And he went forth.
Conquered.
And to conquer. In other words, that every time Jesus moves in your life and help you over one thing or another. You've got to give God glory.
Man.
Because you didn't get to where you are by yourself.
No, you didn't.
You need to stop worrying about everybody else. Right. You didn't make it through single motherhood by yourself.
Right.
You didn't make it through unemployment by yourself.
Okay.
You didn't make it through the trials and tribulations by yourself.
Man.
God helped you conquer one thing or another. Everybody about it.
Right.
But watch out, because the God says in the word, in the text, that in the text that there's a thief that comes to try to undo what God knows.
Man.
When you obey the gospel, the day you got baptized, the thief came right behind God trying to tear up what was done.
Okay.
And you're wondering why I don't feel joy, and why I don't feel hope, and why I don't feel enlightened by the word of God. Because as soon as God conquers you, and as soon as you came together, verse number 6 says that a pale horse rode out.
And behold,
a pale horse.
And his name is
his name was what?
Death.
Hold on a minute. Every time God gives life, now what did God say I'm going to do? I come that you may have life. Isn't that good, church?
Amen.
I don't care if there's some dead stuff in your life. God says, I'm in a relationship with you that I can bring life to what you're going through. I'm on my horse. I'm riding. I'm conquering. I'm helping with your problems. I'm helping you. I'm blessing you that you may have life. Not only have life, but have life more abundantly. But Christian, I'll not look, never have his head down.
Man.
That'll not be safe.
Yes, sir.
But he said, now listen, there are two assignments in the text. The first verse says, there's a thief and a killer and a destroyer. The next says, but I can, that ye may have life and have life more abundantly.
Man.
He has done exactly what he says he's going to do. But Revelation 2 and verse 6 said, I look and behold, there was a pale horse. And he that rode him on the pale horse was death. And death came, and destruction and misery came. And his name was Satan. His job is to undo everything that God has put together. In other words, you wonder why people in the church today and go on tomorrow, you better look for that pale horse.
Man.
You want to know why you feel happy sometimes? Every time you feel happy, next day you're feeling down, you better look who's he's somebody on assignment.
Man.
You better find out who he uses in your life. And you were just happy a while ago. You were giving God praise.
Yes.
You know, the first thing that joker do is talk about, wait, what you got to church for? I don't know what you get out of church. It's that devil shit messing with your house. You look and you don't even know, say, that is by design. That person is there to purposely try to tear up what God has put in your life.
Man.
Here's the problem. If you don't recognize demonic spirits in your life, you will become spiritually bipolar, up sometime, down sometime, according to the spirits that move in the spiritual realm. It's incumbent upon you, as they say in the order of war, to know your enemy.
Man.
I hope not saying amen and looking crazy while
yes.
I'm preaching. I just say he's on assignment.
Man.
Don't mess with that devil. The best way to mess with that devil is to walk up to him and say thank you, Jesus, and praise God and make him run out of here.
Man.
Say amen.
Man.
Do a quick check, see the sitting by on the sign. If you see a devil sitting down, act like I ain't preaching. I know I'm preaching, praise God. The devil is a lie. I know I represent my city. You was a liar to say I don't represent my city. Amen. Amen. Like, hey, I know I'm preaching. If you that's why sitting now, they won't shout at me. Would you walk up to me telling the devil's a lie? And you won't praise God or run more. Amen.
Man. Yes, sir. God. Man.
Amen. Praise God. Y'all so kind, so kind. It's important for you. As believers, I'm going to get through it. It's for you believe here. To stop living your life, acting like Jesus is the only thing moving.
Man.
All right. You act like that Monday morning coming, and nothing bad could possibly happen.
Mm. Okay.
You act like when you walk around,
uh-huh,
that what you're looking at is flesh and blood on.
Well.
I stopped by to tell you, Ephesians 6 and 12 says, but we wrestle not against flesh and blood,
well, what
but
we
against wrestle? Principality. Spiritual weakness in high places.
All right.
Folk that's not trying to praise God or praising the enemy.
Man.
That number one job is to stop you from being happy and
yes,
getting what
sir.
God has for you.
All
folk
right.
that you see that's not giving God glory in their life, that number one job is to make sure you don't give God glory in your life.
Man.
The devil's job when he has just a little while is to have all of us get quiet and hate God. But God said that these should hush their mouth. The rocks would immediately cry out.
Man.
It's the enemy's job to make us hate each other, to look crazy at one another, to become divided so that he might conquer and undo everything that God has put together.
Man.
God put together family.
Yes.
But they're a family problem. God put together marriage. But they're a marriage problem. Everything that God has done, the enemy's job is to undo. And all he can undo is you don't recognize his tactics in your life. So when you take this lesson with you, say, I'm going to start watching for folk on the side. You walk up to somebody, ain't getting nothing to them, just said, how you doing? They don't speak. Don't get mad if they didn't speak. Just say,
they're on the side.
They're on the side. You got a joker, won't pay you back in money. No, he owe you money, playing around. Don't get upset. Just say,
you're on assignment.
And then tell him he got 10 days to get my money. I'm going to be on assignment. Amen. I'm going to be on assignment. Amen. You walk around, somebody cut you off, almost hit your car. Don't start cussing. That's his job, to cut you off. Your job is not to start cussing. Why? Because he's what?
On assignment.
He's on assignment. Sometimes you get up and your girl ain't acting right. Don't spend your time on him. Just keep doing what you're doing. Because she's
on assignment.
Sometimes your man not doing what he's supposed to do. Instead of spending your time trying to make him, you can't fix him because he's
on assignment.
He's on assignment. And when you understand the stuff and moving around in your life, these folk are on assignment. As soon as you understand that, the sooner you enjoy the peace and the harmony that is in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. If you want to know how to have peace in Christ, just recognize folk in your life who bring peace and joy and harmony in your life.
Amen.
You know what I mean? It's not a whole lot of folk that you know that actually make life better. Not a whole lot of folk that you meet that you can enjoy a good laugh with. Not a whole lot of folk that buy you a hamburger instead of you buying them a hamburger. Amen. I said hamburgers, I like hamburgers. Yeah. I expect a hamburger after this Sunday. Amen. Amen. A whole lot of folk. And when you get some folk that make life better, you got to shout out, thank God. You go on assignment. If your person you sitting here with bring joy to your life, would you look up and say, thank God,
thank God.
That you on assignment. Because those folk are valuable in your life. In the last verse he says, I'm the good shepherd. I have a job and a duty. I lay my life down for you. There are not many folk who will sacrifice themselves for you. And because you have a very few of them, you need to recognize them and honor them and love them and make sure you keep them close to you. And don't do like that they say keep the enemy. Don't keep the enemy because he's on assignment. But keep those folk that love you close to you.
Amen.
Because they'll bring you joy and happiness. If you're here this morning, remember the Lord's church, then you just simply need to repent of your sin and say, Lord, help me to be more watchful. Help me, Lord, to be more powerful.
All right.
Help me, Lord, to recognize the folk on assignment in my life.
Amen.
Everything that's not walking contrary to your word in my life. Everything that's causing me to lean to the left where the goats are. Lord, I need you to remove it from me. Stop trying to change folk who are on assignment because they know that they have a little while. They've committed themselves to the enemy. Stop trying to make folk love you. They're never going to love you. That's not their assignment. Folk that don't like you, that undermine you, that's not supporting you, they're never going to start. door. When you leave here today, leave here with your head on the swivel, recognize that some folk on the side for the devil and the others on the side for God. And when you get somebody who's on God's side, y'all ought to get together and sing in the sweet by and by.
Man. Just
see
as I am.
You see what I'm saying? All right. Come on.
Oh.